want to start this. I want to try something new, something I've never seen on YouTube yet. At least I haven't seen it. I don't know if other people have been doing it though, but I wanted to try Confessionals. So the way I look at vlogging is it's just like reality TV, but it's that person that's recording it. Does that make sense? Like, you're still seeing the reality of what's going on with whoever it is that you're watching. So I feel like, boom, when I'm editing and I'm going through my videos and I'm just like weak as hell, or just my reaction, so I figured that would be something cool to add, like do a confessional of me, just my reactions to my own video and any extra stuff I want to add in there, anything else that I have to say that I didn't say in that moment. So now y'all know why I'm sitting here. So first thing that I wanted to talk about is I just want to let y'all know that this vlog, this is my first weekly vlog, and this vlog has a tad bit of vulnerability in it. I'm not 100% comfortable just completely throwing all of me out there, letting y'all get to know me slowly and some of the things that I've been going through. So this vlog here is about trauma. If you are easily triggered by discussing trauma, traumatic events, whatever the case may be, I would suggest maybe not watching this vlog. There's a lot of funny moments, but there are a few triggering moments. Hello y'all. Gotta find something. Out of my fucking luggage. Oh, here it is. Had to find this. So, me and my sister about to head out. We randomly decided to go to a smash room today. I've been thinking about it. I thought we were going to go tomorrow, but we're going today because she's off. But I have been thinking about going to a smash room, or just taking the initiative to let out my trauma, my anger. I'm the type of person that is very slow to anger. I think I just don't like people being able to see me out of character. Deep down, I still feel angry, even throughout, you know, therapy and when I was on medication and stuff like that for depression and anxiety. I was still harboring a lot of trauma. I was just storing a lot of trauma in my body. I don't really know how to let it out. I still don't feel comfortable like lashing out on people when they make me angry. I just don't feel comfortable doing that. But I'm like, there has to be another way to let out all of my anger, all of my sadness. And so I had looked into a destruction room. Found one a few cities away, so me and my little sister are gonna go out there and I'm gonna try to release not all of the trauma, because I know I'm not gonna be able to get all of that out in one session, but I want to make that a routine, maybe, I don't know. And then we're gonna go out to eat to this really nice restaurant that is new over there, and then we might do a little bit of shopping because I want to go to Lululemon. I shopped at Lululemon for the first time over the weekend. And while one set cost damn near $300, I got this set that I have on, and a headband and three scrunchies. I got all three scrunchies in my hair right now. And that shit came out to like $270. I was like, oh, fuck no. Walked out the store like, I will never shop here again. Put that shit on and said, oh, they can have all my money. They can have all my money. It is so comfortable. It snatches me. Like, it just... I look the fuck good in this shit. So yeah, I just wanted to record this before I head out, and I'm so pretty, before I head out, because I'm not gonna, it might end up being late tail, and I don't know if they don't take. What's today's date? The 21st? 22nd? I'm not, but I don't think we should be smashing stuff to Summer Walker. Excuse me.
Yep. And just tighten it all up with a bunch of bullet. Alright guys, so I wanted to go over a couple things with you guys before we're able to start. We also have the weapons over here you guys can use to break glass items with as well.
I did not know my fucking lips was gonna turn blue from that damn drain. I forgot we did get some.
Cauliflower steak.
It's cauliflower steak. You gonna eat that pita bread?
I'll take it.
Listen here. Let me tell y'all, since I've gotten my appetite back, like since I've gotten 80% better with my mental health, I feel great and I'm always fucking hungry. I finally gained majority of my weight back because I've been eating, and just know that I am enjoying my time being a fat ass. I haven't been working out for real. I've just been letting myself be a fat ass. Hi. My titties look freaking huge. I got this shirt and this shirt's too small. I got a size 2 in this top because in their jackets I wear a size 2. So I was just like, what the fuck? My titties growing, y'all. And I don't know why.
Alright, now look. Because I already know how y'all be. Oh, she gaining weight. Titties getting bigger. It ain't what y'all think. And it ain't possible. Before y'all start trying to throw that shit out there, mint might be da-da-da, mint ain't shit, but thick. Okay? Let me nip that in the bud now. It's completely 100% impossible. It's been fuck these niggas. Period. So it ain't possible. But I feel like, being that I'm finally gaining my weight back, I'm gaining weight, like, up here. And then that shirt wasn't helping, though. That shirt was really too small, but I didn't feel comfortable trying it on in the store. So I thought, I wear a size 2 in the jackets. I should wear a size 2 in the top. No.
But they are. I don't know what that is about. But today, I was trying to go to this boutique. I hate a mirror. I hate when he's not in his office. He just went to lunch. I'd be like, bro, like, you really don't, are we not on the same page? Like, the world, the sun, the stars, the moon revolves around me. How dare you take lunch when I need to talk to you? Like, where's the disconnect?
Yeah, bitch. That's your butt.
Thank you. Don't y'all say nothing about my armpits because I did not shave them. But like, the hair is just growing in pretty thin, so it's like I can get away with it for a little bit. I am funny. You hear me? Y'all probably like,
why are you trying to have a seat out?
I can't get jiggy with it. It's not comfortable. So, hey.
I might want it. I should come in on the ballet, but I picked you at the gate. See you looking back now, watching me, watching you, watch us go off track now. Drive me crazy, the way you turn a no into a yes, fuck a maybe. Swallow, give me promise, our parents, you would use those for babies.
I hate when I really like somebody. I don't know, niggas be thinking you playing. Like, oh, you're not really gonna wear. What, because I was obsessed with you? That's the obsession could go away. You gotta go away. I had a horrible pimple right here. Getting just a mess. What is this? Ooh, the mustache shadow. Ooh, I'm still cute though. What are you talking about? Shopping at an actual like boutique. I'm not gonna hold you. You know, I usually shop on like, I'm a Shein type of person. I like Shein. So I guess I didn't expect that daggone place to be that expensive. But don't get me wrong, I got a big bag full of shit because I should have been adding shit up. I think I just went in there and picked a lot of stuff up because I thought the prices was gonna be reasonable. No. Because what just happened in there? And you know what? I'm not gonna hold y'all. Like, normally, like, if I would have saw that price, I would have said, we're gonna have to figure something out. Take some of them things off. Like I said, it's a boutique. So, them girls in there, first of all, was not letting me hold on to any of the items that I was picking up. Oh, can I take that for you? Can I take that for you? But like, they weren't approaching anybody else in the store. I know what y'all thinking. Oh, nah, why would you even buy from there then? Like, I want, bitch, because this is some cute shit in there. And I want it. Whenever I go out, like, shopping somewhere or whatever, I have like a certain number in mind. I'm not going to go over this. But that the prices of their clothes was gonna be reasonable. I thought, all right, I'm gonna pick this up, make sure it's my size, I'm gonna grab this, grab that, all right, cool. Had I went into H&M, Target, shoot, even American Eagle, Abercrombie and Fitch, if I would have went into those type of stores and grabbed that much stuff, and they sell like the same type of stuff, had I did that, it would have been like a couple hundred dollars cheaper. I'm telling you, I did not expect that price. That price is out fucking outrageous. I will never go back. I'm glad that I got as much stuff as I did, so that I will never go back. What is going on? This woman literally had both of her kids split the fucking pole on purpose. I ain't never seen no shit like that in my life. She literally said, yeah, let's split this pole. Yeah, let's split. You split this one. Now you split this one. Ma'am.
Everybody else just put up on us. Forward circles, we can never condone us. Bigger
plans. Please stop music.
I'm about to hit traffic.
Everybody knows it.
Huh? Say your name, what?
Yo.
All crying. So I had cut that part out because I started to talk in circles like I always do. But basically what I was about to say was, oh, boom. How like later on in the day you'll randomly remember what you dreamt about. Migos made me remember my dream that I had. And it was an off the wall fucking dream, yo. It was about this guy that I was like madly in love with back in college days. The reason why Migos had reminded me of it was because back when I was in college, all I listened to was Migos. Dream that I had, y'all. What happened was my sister drove me cities away for me to break into that man's house. I was breaking into that man's house. I have no idea. So that was so random. That was such a random dream, child. I don't think I would do that in real life. I had to pause because would I? Not to him, but would I do that? Am I that crazy? I would do that. Yeah. Not a real confessional.
So this quality about to be trash. Quality? Quality? Quality about to be trash just because I'm recording from my phone and I don't have like no, you know, extra lighting right here. But we're about to go downstairs. I have a new painting that's being dropped off. And I just wanted to tell y'all that before I go downstairs and show y'all this random ass painting.
I'm vlogging. Yeah. Hi, how are ya?
Bed. I might need to use that other lens. Hold on. Child, I had to stand on my bed to get this. But basically, this is the painting. That light is crooked and it's really pissing me off. But I'm too short to fix it. So, this is the painting.
There we go. Right now. There it is. I put it right there.
I hate when you sit down and you lose everything you sat down with.
I was trying to talk about this earlier when I was driving, but I guess I couldn't get my mind right or talk right. I don't know. But I was trying to say that if you are wanting to get into vlogging, but you feel like you don't have the right equipment to start your vlogging and everything, I just wanted to encourage you to go ahead and get started. If you have an iPhone, you have enough to get started on your vlog. So by the time y'all see this, my first vlog should be posted. Half that vlog I recorded with my Canon camera and the other half with this phone. This is an iPhone 14. I have two phones. One is for my personal phone and other one is for content. I just use this phone for like TikToks, reels and stuff like that. And when you build up on a lot of like videos and pictures in your phone, it takes up a lot of storage. I got stuff in here. You see what I'm saying? I got old text messages that I gotta keep receipts for. I'm not deleting. Yeah. At pictures from years ago that I don't want to delete. And I know I got iCloud. Now, I'm saying that because certain people know what I'm talking about. Because certain people try to mess up my shit and they think that I don't know that they tried to mess up my shit. All over here like, what's going on, man? What's the tea? Just know that the person that's supposed to know what I'm talking about, that know what I'm talking about, they know what I'm talking about. And I know what you don't, but you think that I don't know that you did, that you was, that we was talking, that you talked about, that you did. Bitch. I know what you tried to do. I feel more comfortable recording off of this phone when I'm out and about because when people see a big camera and someone's vlogging and stuff like that, they think that the world revolves around them. And really it doesn't. It revolves around me. And so they think that you might be recording them or whatever. People just look at you funny, especially here. Like, this isn't the city. So there aren't a lot of vloggers here. So people aren't used to seeing big cameras around. The quality, people make it seem like there's such a drastic quality between the two, and there is not. I record off this phone a lot, and I'll post on Instagram, TikTok, and whatnot on my story, yada, 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 take pictures off this phone, all that stuff. And people will be like, what are you using? And I'm always like, my phone, my iPhones. When you're using this phone, and you can, this is also a hack for when you take pictures, but I'll explain that another time. You have to keep it, please focus, 4K. Right here, is it on that? Yeah, 4K
60. You have to keep it on that.
Then make sure that your lens, your camera is clean. The only difference is, like, to me, in my opinion, is the focus. I don't know what the word is. I could look it up, but that's just gonna take. But like, you see how everything in the background is blurred? It's even more blurred when I use my 30 millimeter lens. This is Sigma. So I got the Canon EOS M50, and then I use Sigma lenses. It's the same on your phone when you use the back camera, but it's just not as blurred. The only problem that you ever have to worry about with using your phone camera, the front camera, is the clarity, like lighting, if that makes sense. I said clarity, but what I mean by that is it's not gonna be clear if the lighting is trash. Get a ring light, or you can order a little clip light thing from off of Amazon for $20 or less. So this is a clip light. It's the, I don't know how to pronounce this word. I call it newer, but it's two E, so I don't know if it's newer or what. But this is the clip light. It goes up, it goes down, yellow, mixed, white light, whatever. Hold it, turn it off. So yeah, not my thing about to die. Hold on.
Since my last vlog, I'm finding myself use my phone more than my camera because it's easier and it's quicker to just edit from off of this phone. So a lot of people use Final Cut Pro, but that is expensive as hell. Or you can use iMovie, whatever. But there are editing apps that you can use on your phone to edit, and then you can just directly upload your stuff onto YouTube. It's not that deep. You don't have to get a whole camera. And since I'm doing like my editing and stuff like that, and this is my front face camera, and it was still clear. Only that, but the sound is clear too. Everything's clear. Use your fucking phone. Just use your phone. Just make sure the lighting is fine. That's it. That's it. That's all. And if you don't have a laptop to or a computer to edit your video off of, there's apps up here. I like Splice to do my edits. If I'm using my phone, I like to use Splice. Vixer is also a good one. Vixer is good if you like certain fonts and stuff like that. I use that for TikTok and Reels. It's just easier, in my opinion, to use your phone.
She telling me no, why you wrong. Bitch, fuck your nigga.
It's such a nasty day, y'all. It's not even nasty, like, it's not raining. It just looks nasty.
Thank you. Yes, please.
Smell that I would go for in my house. Well, I mean, I like fresh linen. I don't know. This smells really good. But where would I even put? Bathroom? It would be a good smell for the bathroom. It's this. It's the only one that I see. Ooh. So, man, I should not have moved. But, you know, since I'm vlogging, I ain't want to come off like I'm rude to y'all, because I'm not rude. And I thought that she was going to say excuse me as she passed by. She said nothing. I should have threw the damn card at her. She said, good card.
So in that moment, I was really irritated. Because I was just like, ma'am, that's rude. That's mad rude. But it's like, okay, so if you look, you can see that she has headphones on and stuff like that. I know that when people wear headphones in public, they usually don't want to be bothered, and they usually aren't comfortable talking either. It doesn't excuse the rudeness, but like, just looking back at it and kind of having a knowing that that's what it was, I'm not like irritated by it anymore. But I don't know, you know, it is what it is. She should have said excuse me, but at the same time, I understand why she didn't. So, yeah. I handled it very well.
Because I feel a little tired, and I always feel that way when I drink matcha. This is the milk. It's oat milk, though, but, like, any type of creamy drink, anything that's, like, milk-based, it don't matter what type of milk it is. Oat milk, almond milk, rice milk. That shit knocked me out like a damn baby. And for some reason, whenever I'm out and about, or I'm not home for too long, I get overstimulated. Because I hate that for me. Because I wasn't always like this. I know I want to deep clean my house today, but I know you fucking lying. But yeah, the reason why I came here was because I needed some cleaning supplies. I had bought some floor wash, and it spilled in my fucking trunk. Now my trunk smells weird. You would have thought it would have smelled like cleaner. I wouldn't have been. I know y'all heard that radio playing. Who put batteries in that radio? I'm good. I think I got everything that I need from here. I was gonna go to a fabric store and get some head wraps, but I don't really feel like being out like too much longer. So, fun facts, I might as well tell y'all, because I'm sure y'all probably like, why she feel like this, you know, being out and about, like, why is it such an issue? So, back in July 2021, vulnerable moment, someone tried to snatch me up. It was very traumatizing. I'm not gonna go into like detail of like the whole story of how it happened. I didn't start leaving my house outside of like training clients. I had started training clients again January 2022. But besides training clients, like from July to December, I didn't leave my house at all. So you know I was spending mad money on the Target app, Instacart, DoorDash, Uber Eats, all that stuff. I was not leaving my house. When I started training clients, I kind of started feeling a little bit better about myself as a whole. But I still didn't feel safe like leaving the house outside of training clients at the gym. And the only reason why I felt comfortable training clients at the gym was because we had a private gym that I worked at, and I could lock the doors. So it wasn't a gym where anybody can just walk in and do and work out and do whatever they want. You have to be training with a trainer. The disrespect. There we go. Yep. Like, that's ridiculous. That you want to fall that bad, that you want to be that dramatic. But anywho, I didn't start leaving my house until like the springtime, and that was because at first I was someone like I wasn't really leaving the house by myself, and I was traveling and I wasn't traveling by myself, so I had kind of got used to being outside again, outside of work, and then I felt better. But being outside for too long, it's weird. It's like, you know how they say when you've grown up in toxic or like traumatic environments, and how like your peripheral, like you can see everything, you can hear everything. I can see everything, I can hear everything. I'm kind of like just paranoid. I'd be in like a constant fight or flight mode, or just flight mode. And feeling like that for too long makes me just want to go home. It's uncomfortable. My face keeps saying a hell of a lot. We'll be right back.
Hey. Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Been too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, your sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. You got it, girl, you got it. Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bag and now you quality. You just took it off the line, no mileage. Waiting in you the DM looking fine. Talking while you come around and now they starting. Through the coupe 17, no guidance. You be staying low, but you know what the price is. They ain't never got you, know it being modest. Popping, shipping only cause you know you popping. Yeah. You got it, girl, you got it. You got it, girl, you got it.
Little baby in a bag and a Birkin. No 9 to 5, put the work in. Laws and all, I love them all. So me a birthday. Baby girl, you got it, girl, you got it, girl. You got it, girl, you got it, girl. I don't wanna play no games, play no games. Fuck around, give you my last name. No, you died of the same damn thing.
Like the last, not half of the vlog, but like almost the last like 10 minutes was just me cleaning and getting ready the next morning. Friday was just a self-care day, so I had did my skincare routine and everything, and I ended up just sitting in the bed and tried to get started on my editing and whatnot because I knew I had a lot to edit. Also was sitting there talking in circles with this daggone mask on my face. I feel like what I was talking about was too vulnerable, so I just put sound over it. It was just a little too, I want the vlog to just be sad overall. I feel like it's a very funny vlog. I didn't want to have this vlog just be all about like me talking about my traumas, even though that week I was really just in reflection mode. I had a lot of high and low moments when it came to my emotions and just how I felt. I definitely didn't want to end like on like a bad note either. And then my camera died when I was cutting up my mangoes, so that's why there's an abrupt ending. But that's it, y'all. That was an ugly like cough laugh. See y'all later. Let me cut this off.